guys continue to have a fantastic offseason, checking off all the boxes quickly, making a World Series contender, and addressing a big area of need, adding catcher veteran Travis d'Arnaud to a two-year, $60 million deal. Yeah, it's not going to jump off the page to you. It's very savvy. It's very keen. $8 million per year, given the fact that we already have Tyler Flowers in the fold. 1 year, $4 million, $20 million to a couple of guys that have been around the block that understand the catching position and are great for young starting pitching. It can't get any better than that, given the fact that catching is the most valuable commodity almost, because a catcher is involved in every play, and that's why it's really, really expensive to sign a quality catcher, as we saw with Yasmani Grandal. He got an arm and a leg and a money tree, 4 years, $73 million, plus no trade from the White Sox. And if you were going to think about trading for a all-star type catcher, Wilson Contreras or Tucker Barnhart, catchers are just like pure gold to organizations. So it would have cost, let's say, Max Fried and a couple other high-priced prospect capital for that to happen. Not worth it. If you're gonna give up high-priced prospects, you need to give it up for a controllable starting pitcher, in my mind. So this could not have been any better. Travis d'Arnaud is very serviceable on both sides of the ball. I think he will give us a little bit of a leg up in terms of caught stealing. I don't know the numbers, but I feel like he's just a little better in that area than Tyler Flowers is. And he's very serviceable on the offensive side of the ball as well. 263, 16 homers, and 67 RBIs in three separate stops. The Mets, one game with the Dodgers, and kind of a rebirth with the Rays. That usually happens. The Rays just have a knack for that. And one other thing, you might see the revenge narrative. It worked for Odani Echeverria. Hopefully it'll work for an entire season for Travis d'Arnaud. And another factor I don't think people are putting into this is the fact that he can play first base. Given the fact that he came from the Rays, they like to do many different things with their positioning, and Travis d'Arnaud got quite a few games at first base, so he's very capable at that. Just in case we need to spell Freddie Freeman a day, or injuries happen, like happened in the playoffs, we were kind of hamstrung with Freddie, with one-armed Freddie, and no Charlie Culberson on the roster. No Austin Riley. Now you've got a viable option at both catcher and first base if needed. So this signing can't get any better. It didn't cost an arm and a leg. Now you can go out, get a top tier starting pitcher if you want, Josh Donaldson or third base, and we will be set. And I just love the Braves' aggressiveness in the offseason. And we're not doing it and spending stupid money. It's smart investment in both player for the clubhouse and on the field. It's just absolutely amazing in every aspect. I can't wait to watch this season. But let's see how the rest of this offseason plays out. As always, go Braves. We are doing great.